Oh, I didn't see you there. You know, it's that time again. We're Total War players everywhere, settle in for a long winter's campaign. But if you're like me, everyone keeps interrupting you to ask what you want for Christmas. Because history and gaming nerds are notoriously difficult to buy for. So let's take the guesswork out of Christmas together, and make sure you don't get another gift card to Applebee's from Grandma. By going over the top 12 gifts for that armchair general in your life. Number 1, a DNA test. If you're even remotely interested in history, you've probably seen an advertisement for a DNA test. DNA tests are a fun way to make conversation around the holidays. You might find out new and interesting information, like that you're part Congolese and that you're in the 96th percentile for Denisovian DNA, which might explain some things. And in general, they come in one of two forms, Ancestry.com or 23andMe. I've actually used both, and they both give pretty good results. Ancestry.com is significantly cheaper, but it also only tests for DNA groups, where the 23andMe also tests for mitochondrial DNA, Y-chromosomal DNA, and even Neanderthal DNA. But make sure to order them early, because everyone gets them around Christmas time, and you may not get your results back until June. Number 2, Warhammer Yarn Dolls. They're ridiculously cute, one of a kind, and fuzzy. So what's not to love? The board game Risk. You know that before there was ever Total War in your life, you played Risk. And if you haven't played it before, well then have I got a treat for you. It's a game of global domination. And now it even comes in multiple flavors, like Star Wars, Assassin's Creed, StarCraft, and even Call of Duty. And remember that no matter what happens on your Risk game night, it'll still be more interesting than the last season of Game of Thrones. Number 4, a gaming mouse. If there's one thing I have way too many of, it's gaming mice. I personally feel there's a mouse for every type of game. And if you're one of those people that's still using a trackpad, or God forbid, the Dell mouse that came with your computer, it's time to upgrade. If you play Total War and MOBAs, I recommend the Logitech G213. It's like the Logitech Pro, except cheaper and doesn't have a braided cable. If you want the bog standard gaming mouse that everybody enjoys, try the Death Adder Elite or the Logitech G403. They basically feel exactly the same in the hand, and I've used both of them pretty much interchangeably. Or if you're an FPS individual, try the G502. It even comes with a little button on the side that helps you snipe better, and adjustable weights so you can move or fire faster, and RGB lighting. I should also point out that Logitech has a special deal with the Total War people. And actually, the mouse lights up the same as what happens on screen. So if you're playing the Dark Elves, you'll have a purple mouse. Not that you'll see it because it's beneath your hand, but it's still a cool feature. And it works for their keyboards too. Number 5, Warhammer books. On this channel, I give the Warhammer book series a lot of flack, but they're actually pretty fun to read and really inspired a whole generation of people to play the board game and try the games themselves. And if you're just jumping in, I highly recommend you start with some of the more well-known book series. There's one on the Empire, there's one called the Blackhearts, which is basically the Dirty Dozen, and there's even a Malice Darkblade book series that I mentioned in a previous Noobs Guide. But by far the most popular is probably the Gotrek and Felix series. It's fun adventure in a Tolkien-esque world, and you can find them online in the Complete Omnibus series now, so you can get 4 books for the price of 1. Knit beanies. Baby, it is getting cold outside. And let's be honest, you need to put something on top of that balding head of yours. So why not do it with fashion and style? You can use your headgear to be a hero and rescue all the treasures from Lindisfarne after its monks mysteriously died and the abbey spontaneously caught fire when you arrived. Or cure them of their fear of animals by having them fight in your coliseum. And if that's too much, you can always just go as the lazy slob that we all really are. For the 3 guys that played Thrones of Britannia, number 7, the Lewis Chessmen. For the Viking lover among you, there really is no substitute for the Lewis Chessmen. If you've ever been to the British Museum, these are the tiny guys that make up the chess set that you always see everyone talk about. And there's nothing more intelligent looking than having a chess set sitting around your house. Because you all know, you want everyone to know that you don't just play Total War because it's a fun game. You play it because it's the smartest game around. And if that's still not enough for you, you can always say it's your wizard's chess set, and then everyone will nod politely and agree that yes, you are in fact a Gryffindor. Number 8, Warhammer figurines. The sets that started it all. Tiny little metal figures that you can paint with tiny little paintbrushes into a cacophony of colors. But before you get too excited to jump into tabletop gaming, there is a bit of a caveat. You see, the Warhammer fantasy world that we know and love from Total War Warhammer doesn't actually exist anymore. It's now called the Age of Sigmar, and the Age of Sigmar is actually coming to an end in the next 2 years. Thanks to the success of games like Total War Warhammer and Vermintide, they're bringing back base Warhammer fantasy. So it's really not a good time to get into buying new models. In fact, you might be better off buying old models, or in this case, a paint set to repaint old models with, because they should still be good. And you can use the same paint for Warhammer 40K, which is sort of like Warhammer Fantasy, except with Space Marines, and awesome. For the Shogun 2 lover among you, a kimono, because there's nothing like going out to your mailbox when it's cold outside in a bathrobe. Honestly, it lacks style, and nothing says weeb like imported Japanese goods. Just make sure to tie it nice and tight around the center, otherwise when a gust of wind comes by, you might get a bit of a realm divide. Number 10, a sword. You know what no Total War player has ever said? No, I don't want a sword for Christmas. Because let's be honest here, the only thing protecting you from someone breaking in your door and pillaging your house at night is 3 feet of imported Chinese steel. I wouldn't actually recommend swinging it at anything because it's so brittle and cheap, it's just as likely to snap and hurt you. I'm linking the synthetic one here because frankly, I don't trust any of you with kitty scissors. And since they're latex weapons, they even come in really cool varieties. Like the Warhammer is named after Gal Marazz. Number 11, gaming glasses. You only get one set of eyes, and if you're sitting in front of a computer for long times, playing video games, well then frankly, you probably need to have gaming glasses on. They help to block out blue light, they help reduce eye strain, and reduce the risk of certain types of cancer. Now me personally, I have prescription glasses and have blue light blockers built in, but if you happen to be lucky enough to have perfect eyesight, well first screw you and your perfect eyesight, but secondly, protect them. Think of them like safety glasses for computers. Number 12, a knockoff Wacom tablet. You've all seen the things where you have the pen and you draw on the surface and it makes really cool stuff on Photoshop, but it's actually far more useful than that. Now me personally, I get a little bit of carpal tunnel, especially from long gaming sessions, and that pen provides a nice way of allowing you to operate a computer without having to use a mouse. Not only that, you can create stuff with it. And this one has a self-charging pen, 8,000 levels of pressure sensitivity, it draws easily in the curves, and easily manages those long lines. And it's great for all your shitposting needs. And if all else fails, you can always check someone's Steam wishlist. Most people actually do use the feature, and you can find out what games people do and don't have. And if they own all the Total War titles, well then branch out. Try something like Crusader Kings, Europa Universalis, or even the Assassin's Creed games. And there you have it, your 12 options for that Total War player in your life, or you. All of them are linked in the descriptions for this video, and none of them are actually paid product placements. I've bought them all or been given them all with my own money. But if you want to change that before next year, I'm not above a bit of bribery. So from me to you, happy holidays and Merry Christmas out there.